Hey guys, and it happened. The video hands-on of the Galaxy Note 9 is here, courtesy of Mobile Fun, you cheeky, sneaky, slippery lads. They have done it again. And also, Samsung officially announced the new flagship Samsung Galaxy Tab S4, which we're gonna take a look at in a bit. So the live video hands-on of the all-black Galaxy Note 9 is here, and yes, this is not the Note 9 clone model that you have seen on YouTube. It's the real Galaxy Note 9 model, and with the first look, it's super hard to see if it's really the Note 9 because it is so similar to the Galaxy Note 8, but turning it around, you're gonna see the difference, which is with the fingerprint scanner, it's now below the camera sensor instead of being next to it. So it's much better and comfortable position compared to the Note 8 and the S8 family. And you also see that the vertical variable aperture camera system from the S9 Plus is finally here. And this variable aperture camera system from Samsung is one of the best camera system you can have on a phone in 2018. Now, unfortunately, it's a very brief hands-on, so no S Pen look or software sneak peek. Speaking of software, iCineverse tweeted out saying Galaxy AI UX will be coming with the Galaxy Note 9 along with the Bixby 2.0, which is said to be massively improved compared to the Bixby with the Galaxy Note 8. Along with the Note 9, you will see this wireless charging duo as well, which will allow you to wirelessly charge your phone and your Samsung Watch at the same time, and it's coming with a thicker fast charger and USB Type-C connector. So there you have it guys, Galaxy Note 9 completely broke down with all the leaks and everything, and the video leak was the final thing that we were waiting for, and it's here. I'm interested to hear your thoughts on this. Will you buy the Galaxy Note 9, or are you gonna settle with the Note 8 and wait for the S10? Let me know in the comment section below. In case you still don't know, the Note 9 is coming on August the 9th with an expected price tag of $950, along with exclusive access to Fortnite for Android. Now, Note 9 wasn't the only S Pen Galaxy that Samsung has planned for us. They also announced the brand new Samsung Galaxy Tab S4. A huge shout out to the talented Lars from All About Samsung for sending in the exclusive hands-on footage of the Tab S4. Be sure to check out his channel and subscribe to him for the Note 9 hands-on as well on August the 9th. Now, the Tab S4 has some noticeable changes. First up is the depth of the home button / fingerprint scanner, and because of that, it has less bezels than the last year model and the Apple's 10.5-inch iPad Pro. It uses intelligent scan feature just like the Galaxy S9, which combines the iris and facial scanner. The display is finally 16:10, so now your video's experience will be better than the Tab S3. We got 4 quad AKG tuned speakers with Dolby Atmos Sport, so you'll get a great audio experience. Under the hood, it's gonna rock a Snapdragon 835 processor with 4GB of RAM and a 7300 beefy battery inside. Now, one of the cool features of the Tab S4 is the new DeX UI mode, so you can go to the DeX mode without connecting to an external source or using DeX. It's all on the tablet. It will allow you to make your workflow better by giving you a laptop-like experience, opening multiple applications on one screen at a time, etc. The Tab S4 supports up to 20 windows via DeX mode, and you can also expand and resize windows at will. The S Pen has pretty much the same features as before, with the new live message feature added from the Note 8. Unfortunately, no Bluetooth connectivity with the tablet S Pen, which we will definitely going to see on the Galaxy Note 9. So overall, I'm happy that Samsung is still bringing the fight and not letting the Android tablet game die versus the Apple's iPad Pro lineup. It's hands down the best Android tablet that you can buy in 2018. So yeah guys, that's the latest Samsung news. Galaxy Tab S4 is official and Galaxy Note 9 is just a few days away. Let me know your thoughts. What are your thoughts? Are you upgrading to either of these devices? And stay tuned for more coverage, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace out.